Well, if you like it wild, reckless, and Western, you gotta be loving this Craig Cameron Cowboy Challenge. Hey, if you love cowboys, you like horses, and you like action, hey, we got it all going on right here. We're gonna put these guys through their paces, and we got all kinds of champion cowboys and top horses that are gonna go to work. Hey, this is something you're gonna like. You're gonna wanna track it all the way, and guess what? We got $16,000 up for grabs for these guys in championship buckles as well. Get to know these guys, pull for your champion, and that's all coming up right now on Ride Smart.
The Craig Cameron Cowboy Challenge on Ride Smart is brought to you in part by Ranch Hand Spray Lubricant, Total Equine, unparalleled excellence in nutrition, Cactus Saddlery, Bradshaw Hay, Pro Earth Animal Health, makers of Equisure, and by Diller Hay Feeders.
I want to tell you about the hay-saving feeders made by Diller that we've been using for several years here on the Double Horn Ranch. These feeders are designed for large, round, and square bales. They feature a wide body design and hay basket with end panels, which limit consumption and waste, which saves you money. With their heavy-duty construction, every Diller feeder is covered by a 3-year warranty, and it's made right here in the USA. For more information on Diller horse feeders, go to DillerEquine.com. Cactus Western Saddle is a true work of art that begins with Herman Oak leather and combines the finest craftsmanship and materials available. Each piece is handcrafted by master saddle makers to be functional, authentic, and attractive. Cactus Saddlery, we understand exactly what you expect from your saddle and build it to fit both you and your horse. See the complete line of Cactus Saddles at your local Cactus Saddlery dealer or visit them online at cactussaddlery.com. I want to tell you about a great new product that I'm completely sold on, Equisure. Hey, this is the product that neutralizes the acid in your horse's stomach and takes down the acidic level. That means a happier, healthier, calmer horse. Whether you're showing horses, traveling, or trail riding, whatever, this is a product that I carry with me all the time, and it's insurance for that healthy horse. Hey, check it out. It's a product that you'll love, you'll use, and you won't want to be without. Equisure. The men that I chose for this, they really are the real deal. Cole Cameron, Bruce Cameron, these guys are got my blood running through their veins. Jim Sharp, his partner, Ted Noose, both those guys, I guarantee you, they always come first place. Clint Hopping, Greg Gansko from Oklahoma, and talk about humor and a lot of fun. Runt Ragath, Chris Redden. Now you talk about some real working cowboys and really authentic. Well, we got another wild one coming your way. These guys are going to have to be good with their horses, good with riding just about any horse, and a little speed involved as well. This is my Pony Express race. We're going to be in this 120-foot round pen. Both team members will be in here with both horses. First rider starts dead center. He runs up here. You know, he's got to be careful about the approach. He could spook his horse. His teammate can be holding that horse. He mounts up. He got to go all the way around and stay on the outside of them cones. Comes in here, exchange of horses, goes all the way around. Now his partner, he's got to hit the ground for his partner can get on. Now the other guy's got to ride both horses around, and the second rider has to run the center, kick that cone over, and that's going to be time. Let's see how good they can do. All right, we're moving to the Pony Express, and we're starting out with the team in the number one slot. These are our Missouri Cowboys, the Red Rangers, Runt Ragath and Chris Redden. Looks like Chris is going to be the number one rider. Let's get it on your mark. Get set, go. All right, Pony Express. Now, here he comes. Now, you got to be careful approaching. See how quiet, man, that was a nice step up, and this cowboy's off and moving. And he is covering the background and carrying the mail. Looking, man, that's a pretty ride right there. All right, here he comes. Now he's got to ease it back down. His partner's helping. That's good. Look at this. Look at this. Check that out. These guys are locked and loaded, trying to go for a win. He's riding without any pedals. Old Runt Ragath's a little longer legged than Chris. And what a ride now. This is looking very sharp. Now he's going to ease it right in. Big old stop on the bay horse. That cowboy makes a swing up, and they're off and moving. You better look out for these Red Rangers. These cowboys know how to play the game to win. Look at this cowboy. And look how smooth old Run is. He always looks silky smooth up there. They're stepping from the saddle, guys. That's pretty good work. Good Lord, they're going to be tough. All right, he's got to get down here, get on the ground, and make it into the center. They've got a great, not a good run, but a great run going. That's why they're in the top slot. There he's, all right, he's good. Here we come, get ready, timers, and time right there. All right. Woo, I want to tell you something. I've put together a few of these Pony Express races, and I got to tell you, be honest with you, that might be the best I ever seen it done. These guys are in the top slot, and you know what? I think they're determined to stay that way. We got the green team. They've been hot all day long and have moved into second position, and they're ready to roll. Looks like Clint Hopping will be number one, then Greg Gansko. Here we go again. On your mark, get set, go. All right. Here he comes. Now you gotta be careful in the approach. Look at that horse sit back. See, and we talked about that. The easy does it, and that has already cost him some time right there as he gets into the saddle, and he better get moving. All right, he's on the correct lead. Locked and loaded and around the bend, and they got to stay on the outside of those cones. This is a pretty good ride, looking good. Now he's got to get over here and make a change right there. Oh, what a stop. He's going to try to emulate those other guys. When he does it pretty good, he nearly ended up on back, but he found the seat and looking very good. There he goes on Greg's horse. Now that's a little different, riding another cowboy's horse, but he did a good job right here. Now he's got to get on the deck right quick. Now that you're good, you can mount up right now, having a little trouble getting in the saddle on his partner's horse, and he does a good job of just slowing things down, get the confidence of that horse back. All right, he's in the saddle. They know right now they're already behind, but there's other slots and other money and other points to be made. Here he comes around the bend. Those stirrups are a little long for him. Clint's a little bit taller. He's trying to make the bend right here. Again, you can see the difference in time coming as Greg Gansko makes the exchange. Back in the saddle now, he's on his own horse. You can see the confidence soar right there as that cowboy goes around the bend. Now he's got to get over here. His partner's waiting on him. Got to go through these two cones. Now, again, a test to get off. What a job. Great athletic move, Greg Gansko. Ah, dang it, Greg. I tell you what, he was coming into home base right there. I tell you what, face in the dirt right there, cowboy. All right, moving along in the Pony Express run, going to the bull team. They've had a tough day, but they'd like to pick it up right now, and they got the opportunity. Let's get it on one more time. On your mark, get set, go. All right, Jim Sharp coming in right here. Real smart, just kind of, that approach is really important. You can really spook these ponies. And right now, I'd say they're going to be in front of the last, the green team, just because of the approach of Jim Sharp. Now, this is his horse, the bay horse. And I like his position. See how he's leaning forward? When you're racing, you need to be in a racing position. Hands forward, big loose rein. That's an excellent job. Now he's going to get right here. They're going to try to exchange from the top as well. I tell you what, they said, at the pace those other guys to doing this, and that's smart. Now he's on Ted Noose, big old dapple gray right here, and that old pony trying to pick up the pace. Jim urged him on and doing a nice job sitting in the right middle. Right now they got a good deal going. I'll say now, Teddy, you can go. All right, here we go. Teddy up in the saddle. Here he comes. Now Ted Noose right there. Again, these guys got so much talent, so much ability right here, so much athletic ability as world champion bull riders as they come around the bend. He's got to step off right here. He's going to try to do it from the top as well. These guys set the bar. Look at Ted Noose. What a great exchange. This ought to be good right here. All right, coming around the bend. Come on, Teddy. Lock it low. Bring it on in. He's got old Gray really rolling on. All right, he needs to step off and get on it. What a great job. So athletic. And time right there. Woo, that was a hot run right there by the bull team. I hope it puts them back in some points right there. Well, we're down the last team, but this is the team that just won the run and shoot and have moved up into second place. Let's get ready, Cole. On your mark, get set, go. All right, here comes Cole Cameron. They just had a great run. Now he's got to ease it in here. You see that horse kind of saying what's happening? And that's a pretty good mount, pretty quick, and they need to get rolling. All right, here they go. See if that horse changes leads right here. There he goes with the lead change. Cowboy sitting really pretty on a really loose rein. All right, this is a good ride right here. I like the way he's sitting. He's getting more comfortable with this horse that he doesn't really know. Now, they were going to try to make the big exchange, too. This could be tricky right there. That's a big guy, and they do it. I tell you, the Red Rangers made everybody try that deal because they didn't stand a chance if they did. So here we go. Cole Cameron riding another horse he hadn't not familiar with and doing an excellent job. All right, finding the stop. You got to find. Whoa, whoa, whoa. He's got to step off. Yo, go, go. All right, Bruce Cameron up in the saddle on a horse he doesn't know. He got to get around the bend, wasting time, locking low. Come on, cowboy, do something. There you go. He's finally got that forward movement, and he's trying to put the pedal down and garner some speed. Right there. Now he's starting to look a heck of a lot better. When he changes, he'll be back on his own horse, and that'll be a help. Can he do the exchange from the top? Wow, these guys are getting wild. Hits the ground for just an instant, picks up the reins on the move, and Bruce Cameron rolling. Be curious to see what the time is. Right there, a Red Ranger's way out front with a 108. Right behind them, the Bull team. Right there, he's got to step off. Here he comes. What a great athletic move by every cowboy. Time! Right there. Woo! Pony Express race, what a race. And my favorite part, great horsemanship skills by each and every one of our competitors. But guess what? Here's the way she stacked up. Coming in fourth place, taking a little starch out of these guys. They've been pretty sassy. Look at them. They kind of lost their mojo, looks like. Green team. Green team coming in fourth place right there. Guys,
it's that, not that funny.
That'd be only 10 points. Now, coming in third, getting 20 points. Hey, Bandits, good job. And finally, a Bull team stirring the pot right there. Coming in second place, garnering a big 30 points. That's going to help them a lot. But you know what? Still on top. Better look out, Red Rangers. What a run they had. And they picked up the big 40 points. So here's how we stack up after the Pony Express. All right, in fourth place is the Blue team. They're at 110. Sitting in third place, splitting second and third with 155 points is the Brown and Green team. Exactly together, 155. But way out front, Red Rangers, the Missouri Cowboys, 195. So that's the way it stacks up. But guess what? More events coming as we keep this incredible Craig Cameron Cowboy Challenge going. All right, guys, out of the way. All right.
You've been using now Total Equine and Total Bull and Total Canine and Total Deer and Total People Plus.
You know, it's just the way that I want it to be. You know, people comment on my horse, they actually ask me, what are you feeding? Because they got that shine to them. My cattle are better than ever. You know, I'm just coming back from actually getting my back broke, my shoulder, my knee, a horse flipped on me, and I'm back in the saddle doing it all right now. And you know, I want the best, and I feel like with the Total Feed program, I absolutely, without a doubt, have the best. You know, the foundation for any feeding program is a quality hay. Here at the Double Horn Ranch, we trust Bradshaw Hay Company. This is an irrigated and tested hay grown right here in Texas. So when it comes to horse quality hay and great hay for my cattle, I trust the Bradshaw stamp. You know, hay is the foundation every day that we use. And if you're looking for superior hay that can be delivered to you, square or round, trust Bradshaw. Well, we're moving on in the Cowboy Challenge, and this time we're going to some cattle work. They got to separate the cows from the young ones right here, from the heifers. So they're going to let them out that gate. They only got 2 minutes to do it. For every young cow that goes in there, 10-second penalty. Hey, this will really see who is really cowboy and who's really well-mounted. This the Dream Team, Green Team, coming in fourth place. Last time, on your mark, set, go. All right, Greg Gansgrove looks like he's going to be the cutter. You know, personally, I'd have swung that gate the other direction. That would have been my way to do it. Really take care of these cows, and that would have made me a little dab of a wing. Now, he's got to sort the old cows from the young cows, and you guys out there watching will be able to tell the big ones from the little ones. Now, again, there goes one. There's two. Oh, man, he had two. There's three. All right, they're doing pretty good. So right now they're up to three, but don't forget, only 2 minutes to work. He's got a good chance to get a big red one right there. He's gonna slice off three, four, he's got five. Oh, he could have had six right there. Oh, there it goes. Right there. There goes 10 seconds, but he's got a crowd of big ones. I don't know where the time is at, but they got one more. They're over there communicating, and that's what good cowboys do. Right now, they're doing a heck of a job. All right, here they go. All right, and time. 55 seconds with a 10-second penalty. Nicely done. We're going to the Bulls team, man. They made up some ground last time. Finished with seconds and 30 points. And these guys are some good Cowboys. I've worked some brandings with them, and they're the real deal. All right, Teddy and Jim, here we go. On your mark, set, go. All right, Jim Sharp on the gate. Ted Noose doing the cutting. You know, this is really interesting. This is real cowboy work that we do all the time. Separating cows from calves, separating steers from heifers, separating the keeping cattle from the selling cattle. We do that a lot in the business. And you see these cowboys, and Jim and Ted, one thing, they're used to working together. You know, just like Runt and Chris, and they're doing a really nice job. And Teddy's right on the money. You know, Ted grew up roping and riding, and he rode race horses, and he's team rope forever. He's an excellent roper out there, right there now. Okay, you can see they got one old black horn cow that's slowing their deal down, messing up their business right there. Watch Jim Sharp working, and what he's doing is really, that was a great cut by Jim Sharp. Get the gate, time! All right, timers, on your mark, set, go. All right, looks like Bruce is gonna do the cutting on big horse he calls Buns right here. And you know what? The luck of the draw is gonna make a big difference right here with these cowboys. It's gonna make a big difference here. Oh man, these old cow, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. You know, that's a good cut he made right there. There's no doubt about it. When I say luck of the draw, these old big cows are gonna get where they know where to go right quick. Gotta get on in there, and time! Red Rangers, Missouri Cowboys. All right, moving into position. On your mark, set, go! All right, these guys do a lot of day work up where they're from, and it doesn't take them long to get the job done, as you can see. Look at that old run. Boy, and that is a pretty horse. Look at that horse work right there. Got two cows left over here. Now they are mixed up in the batch right there. Let's see what they can do. Three big ones. Oh man, look at that horse cut. That's pretty work. And that's a nice job by both teammates working together. Got one old black cow left. Let's see what they can do. Boy, and the brown team was really, really fast. And time! All right, we're kind of settling the cattle a little bit, kind of stirring the pot, where it's going to be even for everybody. You know, those old cattle get smart in a hurry, especially the older ones, but guess what? This time they got to sort the younger ones out the gate, and these are truly fresh cattle for sure. And we'll see, we're going to start with our red team. And these guys have been hot all day. Let's see if they can keep it going. All right, guys, get ready. On your mark. Get set. Go, timers. 2 minutes. All right, Runt Ragged's going right back to work now. I'm going in the opposite order. Now they're trying to get the little cows out, and these are these old fresh cows, and they're going to be a little bit tougher, really test these old boys. That's three. Now you watch, they're going to have to watch that gate of them cattle liable to come back on them. So this is when you got to have eyes in the back of your head. Look at them old big cows trying to get out that gate. Little cows saying, man, what are we doing, and where do we go? There's a nice cut. And we're going to count how many. Boy, he needs to get on that. Boy, he loses them right there. Boy, and these are tough. This is going to get tough. Oh, Chris would like to come over there. That's two. That's two. All right. There's 10 of them. Wow, look at the cut they got going. Look at the cut. He needs to get that gate. Look at that. What a nice job. All right. These guys are getting hot. That's good. Time. Wow. Woo-hoo. All right, boys. Here we go. On your mark. Get set, go. All right, looks like Bruce, they're gonna stay. They were really good the first time. They're gonna stick with Bruce doing the cutting. All right, There's three of the, oh wow, and they're gonna be a little tougher. You see, I had looked like you had three, and they split right down the center. Here come them older cattle, which definitely make it tougher. All right, now there's a good chance to bring something over. You know, they gotta work together, and you gotta be able to read cattle. You know, reading cattle is something only done by getting in the pen and knowing where to put that pressure. Now, that was a very decent cut right there. Here comes two more. Oh, gate man was a little slow right there. And it cost him a cut. Let's just see what happens. There's a big cow, because those big cows are a 10 second fine on these guys. Boy, and I'll tell you what, he just right now, open up. Now he needs to open up, open up. Get behind, he's gotta be quicker. Gotta be quicker than the cow. Man, this is not easy. And you know what? These old fresh cattle, sometimes instead of getting gentler, they might get a little tougher. They might get worse before they get better. And right now, they're having a hard time, even though they had the fastest time to begin with. The time's gotta be getting close. Oh, there's a 10 second penalty right there, and that's gonna hurt. Oh man, the cow, Cole does a good job of saving them right there. Time! Okay, here's our bull team. Let Jim Sharp get on the gate. Here we go. On your mark, set, go. All right, their time has started. You know, we watched these guys a minute ago and they were really, really good. You know, they've worked together at a lot of brandings, and Ted Noosa, really excellent. Boy, look at that bunch. If they could open wide right now, I'd really open that gate. That is a nice job with a cut of three. They got another one right there. He's got two of them right there. Oh, and that big, you know, that's that same old brown high horn cow causing the same problems that the brown team had. Boy, he's got some right in the gate over there. We need to, again, keep those eyes. Oh, he's got him, he's got him, he's got him. He got him, he got him, got him, got him. That's a good job. Now he's five, he's even up. Now, look at Jim in the gate. That cost him just a little bit right there. You know, when you work cattle, you really, like I said, eyes in the back of your head. You know, a cow's got like a pressure point. Man, what a cut right there. And that is a nice job. Now, I see a couple more. Boy, if they can hustle, this is gonna be a big help to them. Hurry, Teddy, hurry, Teddy, hurry, Teddy. All right, Jim Sharp on the job right there. What a nice job, and time. Wow, woo! All right, here we go. Green team, on your mark, set, go. All right, here we go. Looks like Greg Gansko on the big dapple grays. He's gonna do the cutting. He got one behind him, two behind him. He might ought to pay attention. Well, I believe he missed an opportunity for a cut right there. But I'll tell you what, he's focused, but he sure hadn't made a cut. He got all kinds of cattle right here that he could bring around this way. Man, I think he's missed a couple opportunities, but you know, I could be seeing it wrong. Look at all these cattle over here. This cowboy, again, time is ticking and time is money today. Oh, they're gonna go ahead and take one trash, but that was one heck of a cut right there. Really helped them out. And if they can get it done fast, it's gonna work out real good for them. Good, Greg Gansko doing a good job. They're working together at their end. Time! Well, they got it done in a hurry with one trash cow, which will cost them 10. All they'd do is add 10 seconds to their ticker. And you know what? That turned out pretty decent for them.
Craig Cameron Horsemanship Clinics at the Double Horn Ranch are designed to fit each rider's individual needs. Five different round pens, corrals, arenas, and the original Extreme Cowboy Race Course make great horses and riders.
I learned more in 3 days than I have the first 35 years I rode a horse.
It was like having a private lesson, even though it was a group, it was like having a private lesson.
Yeah, you'll wear out the Wrangler in your jeans, I tell you.
Advance your horsemanship and come ride like a champion with me at the Double Horn Ranch. Craig Cameron Horsemanship Clinics are on the road and rolling strong and coming to a town near you. Check out these dates.
Partner, I'm proud of you. Okay, we've came to the end of our cowboy event, this team sorting that we had, separating the young cows from the old cows. Pretty exciting event. So here's the way she's stacking up. Blue team, that's bull boys, 130 points. And third, brown team, 165. In second place, green team, 185. Boy, and I'll tell you what, reaching way out in front with 235 points. Them Missouri Cowboys, Red Rangers. Good job, Cowboys. And you know what? We still got some more events to go. Thanks for joining us. We're going to keep this Cowboy Challenge going.
The Craig Cameron Cowboy Challenge on Ride Smart is brought to you in part by Ranch Hand Spray Lubricant, Total Equine, unparalleled excellence in nutrition, Cactus Saddlery, Bradshaw Hay, Pro Earth Animal Health, makers of Equisure, and by Diller Hay Feeders. Prize money provided by Taylor Bit and Rental. Jeans provided by KimesRanch.com.